and his colors are very, very different from Amber's. He has those bright greens, a little red and blue under his wings, and his beak kind of looks like candy corn. Now, they do still have the same shape and size, though, so you can kind of see that they are the same species. Now, both of these parrots actually came to us from people who had them in their homes as pets and could no longer take care of them, just like our friend Kiki. Wow. Ernie is still kind of new to us. He also came to us in 2016, so he does have a little bit of stage fright out here. But Amber has been here for quite a few years, and she does have some pretty awesome vocals on cue, so we're going to see if she can share some of them. We'll let her share my microphone with me. Can you say hi, Amber?
You have a snack with us.
Very good job. She has a very, very clear voice.
Ready?
Now, Amber also loves to play games with her trainers, okay. So we're going to see if she can say peek-a-boo. Very nice job, Amber. Now we're going to go for probably my favorite vocal out of all of our parrots. So Amber didn't just learn to mimic humans, she actually learned to mimic another pet that she probably lived with. So let's call for her. Here, kitty, 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 kitty. Very nice job. Why don't we give both Amber and Ernie a round of applause? Very nice job, Amber. Zeus was having a good time back here swinging on his perch, so it was difficult for him to step up. All right, I'm going to walk around with our guest of honor for our Wild Wing show. This is Zeus. And Zeus is a blue-throated macaw. And the reason he's our guest of honor today is because blue-throated macaws are a critically endangered species. So these birds are native to a really small area in eastern Bolivia. Right now, it's estimated that there are only about 150 to 250 individuals remaining out in the wild. So it is very unfortunate, but here at Southwick Zoo, we actually support a nonprofit organization called Association Armonia. And they have a really great program for blue-throated macaws. They've actually created a nature reserve for them in their habitats in Bolivia where they thrive. And they also allow people to purchase nest boxes, which they put out in the trees in Bolivia, to help facilitate breeding and get their populations up. So Zeus, we've been supporting this program for the past couple of years. Zeus is pretty excited about it. And I'm going to ask him how he feels about the fact that we are supporting blue-throated macaw conservation here at the zoo. Because like I said, he does get pretty excited about it. So Zeus, are you excited about conservation? Oh, he's got his mouth full. He can't be excited and be chewing on those treats that I just gave him. I'm going to give him a minute to finish those. Are we ready, Zeus? Are you excited about conservation? Are you excited? Oh, he's jumping the gun on me. Wow, he knows the drill. Are you excited about conservation, Zeus? Yes, you are. How excited. Let's see your beautiful wings. Nice job. Very good. Let's give Zeus a big round of applause. All right, so before we conclude our show for today, we are going to be bringing down a donation bin. If anybody is interested in helping us get a few more nest boxes out in the wild to help facilitate breeding for blue-throated macaw species, we would really appreciate it. So that nest box is going to go over on this platform over here. We want to thank you guys for coming to our show today and learning with us. If you have any questions, please feel free to come on down and ask. And we hope you enjoy the rest of your day here at Southwick Zoo. Thank you very much.